friends, today we are going to learn about how to be a cashless. So what do you mean by cashless? Now when we go to the market, that we have to pay money physically, but the government of India and the government of Maharashtra has started a mission, that is Vittiya Saksharta Abhiyan, that we call in Hindi. So in this mission, what is the main purpose of government of India, Pradhan Mantri and government of Maharashtra, is that to make you cashless. When you go to any shop, at that time you have to give only your ATM card, and through that ATM card you can purchase anything and you can pay back money to the desired person that you want to do. In this process, what is the motto behind this is that in this, through this mission, the government wants to reduce the corruption. When we give money to somebody else, that money is with him. But when you buy something from the market, automatically through that cashless transaction, that what we call that tax, VAT, and so many like that, those money goes directly to the government of India, in the treasury of government of India. So that is very important. This is the main motto of that mission. So in this, you may have some basic questions, how to deal with this cashless, how many people know, how many people have the ATM cards, internet banking and all. But with the use of simple mobile phone, you can do the transaction or transfer money from one person to another. For example, this is a mobile. In this mobile, you go to the dialing space, that phone dialer. In that, you have to press *999# and call. When you call, USSD code is ready. Then it asks you to use the language Hindi or English. First, number one for English, you press English, send it. Then you will get welcome to the *code. Enter the bank name if you want to transfer money. Bank name. So you can put bank of name. Suppose it is Bank of India. So you have to be BOI. Then send. Then again you will get its further instructions. Then it asks, enter 6 digit of the debit card. You have the debit card and it has numbers. So last 6 digit of the debit card, expiry date, that is expiry date and year, separated by the single space. For example, last digit of the your debit card. So you have your debit card, ATM card. In that last 6 digit you have to put, then use the space and enter the validity. The validity is on that ATM card. For example, 11/2020. This is the expiry date of like that. I will show physically. I do have. So this is my ATM card. Through this ATM card, these are the numbers. Last 6 digit you have to put. Then expiry date is here. 5/2014. Expiry is 5/2019. So you have to put that. Then you have to enter the beneficiary. Beneficiary means the person to whom you want to send the money. So add his account number or IFSC code, and then transfer the amount. Then they ask the code number, that PIN number, that ATM has everyone the PIN number. You put that PIN number and the money will be transferred to that particular person. So this is the transfer of money, and you can receive the money also. Okay. Another thing that we want to put through is that here one website is given, www.mhrdgovernment.in, that is called VISAKA. Then download and read all presentations. If you want to know the more information about this, you can go through this website, register as a register for that. So for that registration, what you need? The Aadhaar card number, your full name, you have to put in that. Then upload the progress. So you can upload what you have done. Progress. So you have to upload into that. Then become a digital. Then you become a digital. Digital means there is no need to give money physically. You just show the card, show your course, everything with purchasing, transferring money will be done by that. Then make your family digital. And you help your family members how to do the cashless. So many people don't know. Then make 10 families digital. And at least after making digital family of your own, you can make at least 10 families as digital one. Because it is very easy, we can use it. Now the person who is working in a farm can handle the mobile. So he can handle the cashless also. There is no need to go to the bank, wait in the queue and all. So this is very simple, easy, and without corruption we can do this. If you give money to somebody else, deposit my money, he will go and he will run away. What is the use of that? But when you do by your own on the telephone, so there will be no any mistakes and your money will be sent. That is very important. Then NCC and NLC to make a market digital. And so now you go to the any bank, you go to the scholarship section, you go to any section in this India. So everything works on the cashless, debit card, everything. In bank if you go, if internet banking is there, no need to go to the bank. By sitting at home with armchair, you can send money, you can receive money, you can purchase online. For example, that Flipkart is there, Amazon is there, you can purchase many things through online. Because it's very safer side, because it is blocked by securities. So no one can cheat you. If you give money to somebody else to bring mobile to me, he will get money and will go anywhere. But if you pay through the digital, if you pay through the cashless using the card, using these instructions promoted by Government of India, it is initiated by all the ministries in India. So this is very important. If you do that, and as you are the student, you are the future of India. So it is your duty to make India brighter. In America, if somebody puts his hand in the pocket to bring money, everyone laughs. Because all transactions in America, China and many other advanced countries, they work on cashless. They just show the code, they show the card. There, you know, when we go for a trip and all, we have to pay for what? At the go, we have got what we call for that? Checkout. At the checkout, we have to, we give money physically, but they have the code on their car. They, that machine captures that code and that car goes. No need of giving money. So, it saves the time. These are the things through which we can do the cashless, you know, transaction in our life, and we can become happy. No one can steal the money, and the VAT and all these things are directly goes to the Government of India or the Treasury. So that is very beneficial for us. If we follow this instruction, it's very easy. There is no need of use of smartphone. By using simple phone, you can do that. Do that. It's very easy. Everything is written. You have to read, put the button and do that. If you do this, what will happen? That India will become the advanced country as compared to other countries like USA, France and all. So it is your duty. So whatever I told about this, so do you have any questions? You want to ask any question? Yes?
Sir, if the money can, sir, the money can not transfer.
If?
We have done and we are selling tabhi paise dale the na. Paise kehne the dale. So we, how the fault will?
Means? Comes back to your account and they, there is one message, you are, the transaction cannot be completed due to some error and your money has been refunded to your account. So the message comes. So there is no fear of that. It comes back. Any other questions? Sir, can illiterate people?
Sir, illiterate people can do this work?
Yes, of course, they can do. It's very easy. So, are you agree that the illiterate people can call, they can issue the call? It is like that. So, by using the small phone, the illiterate people can also work on that. We can give a small training for 5 to 10 minutes, they can work like that. Initially, we have to help them. Afterwards, they can do. Before that, they don't know how to use mobile, but now they are using. In the same manner, they will use like that. Any questions? So, finally, what I want to say, you are the bright future of India and making India smarter in this world. So you all should do the efforts regarding how to become a digital India. Now half of the country or the 30% people in India, they are using digital method for payment transfer and purchasing. So I hope you will help your friends, your family members and those people who are coming to you. So I thank you all for listening my broken words. So, and I hope that you will help to become India smarter, greater and digital India.